Everyone, I'm in my new place. I'm not really set up yet, and this flowery wallpaper has got to go. But anyway, Hyper Japan's coming up. It's on the 14th to 16th of July at Tobacco Dock in London. So here's my 10 things I'm most excited for at Hyper Japan. Number one, Haruka Kurebayashi. She's a really colorful fashion model and an icon of Decora and Harajuku style. I'm so excited she's coming to London because she's one of my favorites. She's going to be doing a makeup tutorial on stage. She'll be in the fashion show and there'll be a little performance of music from her band. There's also a meet and greet. You can get tickets from Dreamy Bows and they'll also have some special collaboration items designed by Haruka. Number two, Danny Chu. He's the creator of Smart Dolls and his character Mirai, and I love his story of how he's built up his business following his dream. He also runs Culture Japan, which is a great site for planning your trip to Japan. I've found out so many places to go from reading it. And I love the artwork of his characters. It's on my kanji cards, which were how I started learning kanji. The chibi versions are so cute. He'll be giving a talk about Japan, about smart dolls and his business. Number three, Cakes with Faces. I'll be there with my new stuff, my magical Kyoto tunics, which I'm wearing today, varsity jackets, caps, all my t-shirts, dresses, and everything else. If you're new to Cakes with Faces, I love designing cute and colourful things. You can see them all on cakeswithfaces.co.uk. I also make videos about Japan. You can see them all on my channel, Cakes with Faces on YouTube. And there's lots more on the way if you want to subscribe. If you're planning a trip to Japan and you've got any questions, come and see me. It's my favourite thing to talk about. You can find Cakes with Faces on the upper level on CO4, all the way at the back in the corner in the shop next to Art Box. Number four, anime character VR. There'll be virtual galleries from One Piece and Jump manga, including Naruto, but the best one is a Death Note game where you're trapped in a creepy basement. There'll also be a VR concert from idol group Hop Step Sing. It's free, but you need a ticket. Number five, Japanese food. There's always a really good selection, including some less well-known Japanese foods, so it's a really good chance to try something new. This time, I'm most excited about Sticky Bundits, who do burgers with rice buns. As well as the normal food section, there's going to be some food trucks outside this time. And my tip to avoid the queues is to eat early or late, or both. Number six, music. There's lots of bands and performers of all different styles, including traditional Japanese music. This time, I'm most excited about Moso Calibration, an idol group from Deer Stage in Akihabara, which is where Denpagumi Inc. first started. They're not as hyper as Denpagumi, but you might remember them from their music video where they had really cool light-up skirts. Broken Doll are also going to be there. They're a pop punk band. I went to their shop in Tokyo and their music is really good. They've got a new album out and last time they did a cover of the theme tune from Sailor Moon. Number seven, Hatsune Miku. I know lots of you are Vocaloid fans and there'll be a screening of her concert from Miku Expo in Tokyo, so you can see her live show with all her friends. Number eight, DJ Domo. Now, Domo has been at Hyper Japan before, but this time he's a DJ and a robot. I've got to see this. It's going to be on the stage on Sunday. Number nine, wear a yukata. A yukata is a lightweight type of kimono for the summertime. If you have one or another type of traditional Japanese clothing, wear it to Hyper Japan and you might get a prize. Get a ticket from the press desk, take it to the Art Box stand, and the first 50 people each day get a free gift. Number 10, Chiptune Workshop. One of the performers is Toriena. I'm sorry if I've said that wrong. She makes electronic music with 8-bit chiptune sounds. You can see her on stage, and there'll also be a workshop where you can learn about making music with a Game Boy. There'll also be loads of cosplays, people dressed up in Japanese fashion, traditional arts and crafts, workshops, and loads more. If you're coming by train, Shadwell DLR station is closed on Saturday and Sunday. The overground station is open though, so check your route. Not everything's on every day, so check the schedule before you get your tickets. On Saturday, the day's split into two sessions, so your ticket's either for the first or the second session. If you can make it on Friday, that's always the quietest day. Tobacco Dock is a really cool venue. It's not your typical exhibition hall. It's more like a kind of shopping mall, but it is a bit of a maze, so make sure you've explored everywhere so you don't miss anything, especially my stall. So come and say hello, take a look at my designs, and watch out for my video from the show. See you there. Bye-bye.